In order to create an Umbraco website, we first need to get our hands on an empty Umbraco project. And it needs to run the latest and greatest version of Umbraco as well. Now, there are multiple ways to do this. In this video, I'll show you a couple of them. So let's go ahead with the first one. Download Umbraco CMS from Our. On our community site, ourumbraco.com, you can find the option to download the latest version of Umbraco directly to your machine. There is also an option to get the CMS through Nuget if you're using Visual Studio. When you've downloaded Umbraco, you can either install it on your local machine or on a server. In either case, installing consists of a few simple steps. Now, that doesn't sound too bad, right? In the description of this video, you can find a thorough walkthrough of these steps to install. For this video, however, I'll be setting up an Umbraco Cloud project instead. This is the other way of getting an Umbraco project that I'll cover today. On our website, umbraco.com, the first thing you'll see is the option to sign up for an Umbraco Cloud trial. When you sign up, you will get 14 days for free to test out Umbraco Cloud, and more importantly, test out Umbraco. Umbraco Cloud is the Umbraco CMS, just without all the management tasks like setting up and installing. It'll all be taken care of. You can learn more about Umbraco Cloud and all the benefits and features by following the link I've put to it in the description. So, for the purpose of this video, I've cheated a bit and created a cloud project already. See, I have my cloud project here, with a couple of environments all set up. Now, I've also already cloned this project down to my local machine. This basically means that I have a copy of the entire project that you see here on my local machine, so I can work with it there. During the videos in this chapter, I will be working with the cloud project from my local machine. I'll be using Visual Studio Code with the IIS Express extension to run the project locally, and then I'll be mainly working directly in the Umbraco back office. You can find links below this video to all the resources you need in order to get set up locally. Once you have everything set up, head on over to the next video where we'll be creating our very first piece of content. That was it for this video. I'll see you in the next one.